Chip, is there anything you can put your finger on why, you know, the offense seems to do pretty well at certain stages, and then at some point in the second half it seems to just kind of
I think in this game the third quarter was an entirely different quarter than anybody's played all year long with the amount of rain we had on both sides of the ball. So, you know, it turned into a little bit of a run game both ways. Then when the skies opened up a little bit, you know, we were behind, and we have to throw it every down. We're not good enough to throw it every down.
Why does Collins seem to struggle in the second half passing?
Well, I think sometimes we're down, and then all of a sudden it just becomes a rush game and a lot of coverage, different variations. I think when we can keep people off balance with our run, our play action, we're a lot better. You know, if the game is tied close, you know, it turns into that type of game. But when you get down like we did, you know, all of a sudden it just turns into a throw every down game. That's, you know, we're not built for that right now.
What's your impression of Tom Brady and how he was able to escape some of those?
But, you know, that's why he's a Hall of Fame quarterback. I think that's what, you know, he's not the fastest quarterback out there, but I would argue he's as good as anybody when it comes to being able to move within a pocket. And that's what you saw again he did today. You know, you look at the play he made to Mitchell where, you know, avoided the rush. He's probably a tenth of a second later, Ahmad makes a play, but, you know, that's when you're playing against a great one like him. Those are the plays he's going to make. He had the scramble, kept himself alive, and then threw the ball, almost falling down to Amendola for a touchdown. You know, those are people that have watched him for his career have come to expect that from him, and that's unfortunate for us today, but, I mean, that's just the type of quarterback he is. His ability to keep plays alive, he's as good as anybody, and I think people get misconception, you know, that he's not, I'm not, Mike Vick keeps plays alive and scrambling and all those other things. He's not like that, but his ability in the pocket is as good as anybody that's ever played the game.
Chip, did you notice anything in particular with just how much time, especially early on, that appeared he had to throw?
Yeah, well, I think, you know, there are times I thought we did a really good job of knocking him off of his spot in there, but his ability to move and keep things alive in the pocket is really, you know, what makes him such a good quarterback.
Chip, you guys matched a franchise record for 9 consecutive losses. Mm-hmm. What do you do to keep the players enthused and into it?
Well, that's our job. I mean, I don't think we're, you know, going to take our ball and go home. I mean, that's what everybody's here to do, and that's what our deal is. I think they practice well. They're engaged. They want to win. They're not excited about where we are right now in terms of what we've done loss-wise. But we got to go back to work. That's the only thing that you can do in this situation.
Chip, yeah. when you say you're not a throw-every-down type team right now, what do you mean?
Well, that's just not what we're built for. You know, we don't have Torrey wasn't in today. We don't have a go-to wide receiver that's going to elicit double coverage, and then all of a sudden you're going to get single matchups across the ball, and then, you know, we can line up in empty sets all day long and throw the ball all over the lot. That's just not the way we're built right now.
Chip, is this becoming a lost season anyway? 1-9.
I don't think 1-9 is a winning season.
I mean, are you gaining things out of this team? Moving ahead in any form?
Yeah, I mean, I think I've seen our players develop, you know, individually as you go along. You see players as the season goes along, have they gotten better during the course of the year? And I think you're starting to see that. You know, I think in some situations they had to. You know, we were forced in a lot of situations from an injury standpoint when you lose the linebackers we lost, you know, to have Nick Ballore out there getting the reps that Nick's getting. But I see Nick improving. I think Nick's played better today than he did 4 weeks ago. You know, so those are the positive things that you're building on are watching guys develop and continue to grow as players in terms of where they are. So I see that.
The offense had kind of a tough time in the first 3 drives. That 4th drive, you got things moving. What adjustments did you make for that
play? We didn't really make any adjustments. I mean, we kind of knew what they were going to do coming in, and it was a, you know, kind of a matchup type defense in terms of who was getting on who, and then we had to try to exploit that. We felt like we had to run the ball today to, you know, we really were trying to keep them off the field if we could, you know, and I think we did that with a couple of our drives and ate up some time on the clock, you know, and I think the best thing you can do with Tom is to keep him off the field. So I think we kind of extended some drives there, and I think that benefited us, you know, try to keep it within a 1-score game. You know, the difference is I think we had that long drive. Not sure if it was 14, 15 plays, but we came away with 3. You can't match them, you know, 7 for 3 and stay in the ball game with them. And that was unfortunate when we got down in the red zone there and got knocked back on 1st down, 2nd down. You know, those are things that we can't do against a good football team.
When Torrey's not out there, who becomes a guy that can?
Scott Vance had a couple matchups that we liked. You know, I think his ability at the tight end spot, you know, was really kind of what we tried to exploit a little bit there. And I think you saw him, you know, a couple times we hit him in the red zone for a touchdown. I thought we had him on a deep crossing route late. We just missed him up. But I think, you know, Vance kind of falls into that role a little bit for us.
I know you're busy coaching football today. Did you have any interaction with Mr. DeBartolo, or did he come in and talk
to you? I talked to Mr. D just a little bit. No, he did not talk to the team, but I talked to him.
What did he say?
He just happy to be back. You know, he was pulling for us today. I'm hoping he was going to be our good luck charm today, and unfortunately, I think we let him down. So.
Chip, did it affect the team, the number of Patriots fans in attendance seemed to be?
We just play. I don't think anybody listens to it. Once you get on the field, you're just listening to, you know, the referees and the whistles and things like that. But it wasn't too loud or anything that affected our play on the field at all. So.
Couple more? Kaepernick was under a lot of pressure, especially early in the game. Did you see any miscommunication on the line, or was it guys just getting?
No, I just think there were some individual as the game, they settled down a little bit for it, but a couple of times individual matchups early in that first couple of drives there where guys just getting beaten one-on-ones. Once we got that settled down, straightened out, I think we ended up moving the ball halfway decent.
Chip, I know you don't want to go week to week with it, make an announcement after every game, but is Colin Kaepernick your starting quarterback for the duration here?
Yeah, unless we're always evaluated every week, but I don't think Colin played poor today, so.
Did you have any thoughts on
last
the Patriots? Do they look like the same old Patriots that they used to say, oh, sorry?
Yeah, I mean, as long as they have number 12 and that coach over there, I think they're going to be pretty good.
All right. Thanks, Coach.